There she is, right behind that door. Aunt Flossie, crazy-eyed Aunt Flossie. Day 3 of training. The boys are milking Aunt Phyllis right now. When they're done with that, we're gonna get Aunt Flossie out in the chute and hopefully actually touch her udders. I'm 37% sure it's gonna go better than day 1. I mean, day 1 went pretty good, and it might be hard to beat that this early in the game.
Good girl. Ready, Josiah?
Yes!
Whoa! I'm 87% sure it's gonna go better than day 2.
Are you serious?
I'm that sure it's gonna go better because I'm not sure it can get any worse. Plus, I have 2 tricks that I wanna implement that I think it's gonna make it go much smoother.
And we have a helper today. Big helper, Mike. From part-time permies, also pro chef, also master butcher. Cindy,
hey buddy.
Oh, you're very friendly. Cindy, part-time permies. I'll leave their YouTube down in the description. Let's go get the supplies. Thinking I hope it's in here, Mike. Not quite what I'm looking for.
Ooh.
Is this what I'm looking for?
We're in luck.
Okay,
let me hand you out the stuff.
Here we go. Let's just set these right here.
Good morning.
Que paso los niños?
What does that mean?
Wow, you are doing good. Hay mucho leche. There's a lot of milk. Good job, Jonah. Bien trabajo, Jonas.
What does that mean?
Good job, Jonah.
She's almost milked out.
Good morning. Come on.
Come on, Miss Thing.
Let's set it up.
Set this up.
Okay. Day 2, we ended up with this chute idea. Day two, we ended up with this chute idea that worked pretty well. She comes out of the stanchion, comes through this somewhat narrow area, through a chute leading right to the stanchion, nowhere to go but into the stanchion, followed by a treat. I'm really confident because this worked pretty good last time, but also have 2 new tricks from you guys, actually. Trick number 1. You got it? You got the tarps?
We got lots of tarps.
Let's put tarps over this lane, these gates, so she can't see. If the cow can't see through this, she's not gonna see that there's another side. So let's just put tarps, not on the stanchion, but on the gate. Hopefully I don't have to set this up every time. Eventually, we'll wean her off of this. We'll take this down after we're done. We'll put it up again tomorrow, and you know, as she gets more and more used to it, we'll start pulling tarps down and not putting them in. Okay, plan is she's in that farther stall. I've closed this stall. I'm gonna herd her out, giving her pressure. One cowboy said, give her as much pressure as you can. Those sticks aren't gonna work. I understand that. I am afraid she's gonna kick me, so I'm gonna have a walk a fine line there. Bring her out, let her turn around in here. There's nowhere to go. But that wide, it's not tarped over there. It's gonna be calling her name, those snacks. That's the plan, Mike. Okay, you think it'll work?
I think that's a great plan.
Okay, oh, one more idea. Another idea from a viewer. Josiah, you're gonna shut that chute like you always did. And I've been having, come here, down here, Mike. And I've been having to reach through with my staff and shut that and haven't been quick enough 2 days in a row.
She jumped through?
No, she just backed
up. Yeah.
And we had to do it all over again. So, Josiah, let's get a string.
There you go.
Ooh,
okay, let's tie a couple strings. Maybe one of you can help. And we'll have a string to pull this stanchion, and you'll be able to shut this and pull that string and close those bows.
Oh, but that was my idea. I was thinking that, though.
You were thinking that, too?
Okay, beautiful minds think alike.
Stand behind that and squat down so the cow can't see you. Okay, pull it. Oh, it's going to work. We're going to yell, pull. So you're gonna be squatting down right there. Here, you want me to tie yours up? Actually, you can't do a string.
Why not?
Because yours needs to be pushed. You could do a staff.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get you a staff. Here you go, Josiah, try that. Okay, go, Josiah. Oh, okay. She's right behind that door. She's probably raring to go. What do you think her chances are?
60%.
I'm going 87%, it's gonna go pretty sure. How much, Mike? No cow experience whatsoever.
You've been working on this a few days. I think you're going to be in that 85-90%. I think you got a real good shot today.
Okay, so that's meaning very little trouble.
I think you're
like 100% is just her just walking out through, me not having to shout or press her.
Herself.
Yeah.
Here we go.
There we go, and I can get in there. Come on. Come on, sweetie. Come on.
Hey,
hey, hey, hey. There we go. Going smooth. Let's just take our time. Nope, nope. You're not coming back. I'm not going to let her back up. Look, she's looking for her escape. I'm just going to give her time. You're not going to turn around. You're not going to turn around. Nope, don't you turn around. Come on. Come on, that's right. That's right, honey. Ho, 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 ho. Ho, 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 ho. Ho, 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 ho. Let me see the bucket. I've got her pressure. Oh, oh, pull it. Oh. Hey, I'd say that's 95%. What do you say? In a second, guys, we need to pet her, and we're going to try to touch her udder. We're going to rub her udder and see if she kicks us. Who wants to do that?
I can.
Like, but first...
I touch you the bars.
But first, guys, we got to do the happy dance. Wrap it away. Let's get tarps down, fold them, and then let's pet that cow. It's okay, honey. You'll be taking a neck rub before you know it. You'll be coming in here just to get a neck rub. You're a sweetie. Okay, what do you think my chances are of grabbing this udder without getting kicked? Is she gonna kick? Yes or no?
Yes.
Possibly.
That's a yes, but you'll stay out of the way.
She gonna kick me?
Probably.
I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna give her a little treat, cheat a little bit here. You can kiss me.
Oh,
you can kiss
me.
That's our first kiss. You want a kiss? Is that our first kiss?
Nope.
Okay. I'm not going to make you kiss me. I'm just going to rub her belly a little bit. Yeah. Okay, I want her to still be eating, not thinking about me. She's letting me rub her belly. I'm on the udder. Here we go. All right, I've got a teat. All right, I'm massaging the teat. She's not gonna kick, is she, y'all?
Uh-oh.
Great. Oh! Oh, it's getting too confident there. All right, here we go. Come on, it's okay, honey. There we go, now she's letting me get it. Okay. Good, okay, good. She's gonna be our softest, most gentle, most beloved cow.
You are a sweet thing.
Everybody's got a little special place in their heart for the feisty one, right? She ain't coming this way. She's going out to the field. Good job. She says, I'm out of here.
I'm done with that.
She's gone.
Touching me no more.
Look. Get out of my way, everybody. Woo! Some big dogs. A big dog, an energetic dog. Wait, so you guys are Holler Homestead and part-time permies.
Yep.
Elevator speech, what's Holler Homestead?
We started the YouTube to document our trip around the US on our giant adventure to find our forever homestead.
And we do everything food related, growing, chickens, foraging, and cooking. He's a chef, so.
5 acre personal homestead property.
Yep.
A greenhouse right offside the house. Last project.
Yep.
Amazing. I would, if you want to know where to start with them, check out their off house greenhouse. That helps keep the house warm. It's $300.
About 400.
And their high intensity plants that take a lot of attention are right outside their door.
Yep.
Brilliant. I'll leave the links for all that all up in here.